everyone. Welcome. Thank you so much for joining us this evening. I can see that loads of you are joining us. How exciting. My name is Charlotte McHale and I am Commercial Training Manager for Clarins UK. We are so pleased you could join us this evening for a super exciting event with the Queen of Cleansing, Caroline Hirons. You will have received your cleansing sample kit, so make sure you've got those handy as Caroline will be taking us through every formula in the new Clarins Expert Cleansing range to help you discover the perfect cleansing regime for you. The only sample you won't have this evening is the Gentle Renewing Cleansing Mousse, as we don't have samples of this available yet. But I'm sure that Caroline is going to tell us everything we need to know about this one. We are also pleased to share with you the exclusive £10 redeemable code, which is CHCLEANSE, all capital letters, all one word, that's CHCLEANSE. And this can be used on any purchase over £50 on clarins.co.uk and is valid until the 21st of March. Now, this will only work with the email address you've used to register for the event. So do make sure that you log in. Now, should you want to find out more about the new Expert Cleansing range or have any questions about a particular product, the Clarins Virtual Boutique will be open until 8 p.m. this evening, where our Clarins teams are online and ready to assist. But of course, you are also welcome to pose your skincare questions in the Q&A option at the bottom of your screen, just here in the middle, during tonight's event. And I will be putting them to Caroline a little bit later on. So without further ado, let's welcome Caroline to the screen.
Hello, folks. This is weird. Okay, I've given you the most hideous light I could find just so you can see what I'm doing. Sorry. Have you all got your bag with all of your cleansers in it? Lovely, marvellous. Have you got cotton wool and water and a flannel? I mean, you don't need all of those things, but if you would like them, yes. Okay, lots of yeses. Where is everyone else? See, they need to hurry up and get in here, don't they? They're starting themselves late. They're going to be behind. Yes, we have a flannel. Oh, marvellous. Okay, shall we? I will keep an eye on the comments, but I won't be obsessively looking at them just so I don't get distracted. Let me just get prepped with, I think I'm going to start with a brief overview. Do we all already know enough about Clarins and their current offering? Love your hair, thanks, it's telly hair. Day two of telly hair. Would like to hear a little. On Clarins or the cleansers, because I don't want to sort of take up a load of time, but I can give you a bit of a, oh goodness me, okay. Yes, and there's more. Okay, so Clarins are a French brand. Their heritage is in professional treatments, which is why I love them. What else do I need to tell you? I mean, I've done umpteen videos on Clarins over the years. The most popular one being, by far, the breakdown, and especially the breakdown of the cleansers, which people seem to really enjoy, because I basically went through and said, this is for you if you do this, this is for you if you do this, that kind of thing. You don't need to worry about your code yet, because you've got to know about the cleansers first. So why don't you all chill? stop your panicking. They will take care of you. Don't worry. Okay, so let's do, why don't I start with the one that you don't have the sample of, because it's impossible to sample this kind of packaging. The Gentle Renewing Cleansing Mousse. Oh, I feel like I'm going to do a YouTube video. Look, it looks like this, but it's never going to focus. Gentle Renewing Cleansing Mousse with Alpine Herbs and Tamarind Pulp Extracts. Now, this foams with the action of the pump. It is not full of sulfates, you'll be pleased to know. It is literally one of those jobbies. For me, I would do this as a second cleanse in the evening or a quick cleanse in the morning. Here's the lovely thing. It has AHAs in it. Not super strong glycolic or anything like that. They are part of the tamarind ingredient. So the actual name is tamarind pulp. But look at this. This is a creamy mousse. This is not your typical foaming, drying, Do you know what I mean? You don't have this one because that's why I'm showing it to you now. Guys, I assume you all know me. So can I just say that the smell is sexual? I'm sorry, Clarins, you knew what you're getting, but oh my God. So this is the only one that you don't have. I do. Evil. But it is super, super, super soft. And can we get a little bit of like hearing action there? Oh, lush. Not drying at all. So any skin type. Okay, let me get it off. I did bring, you'll be shocked to know, shocked and stunned to know that I have brand new white flannels. Only the best, ops. I am, however, using a bowl of water, which is sinful, but we do what we have to for Zoom. Can't take this computer into my bathroom. So, and then when we get to the bits, I'll show you on my skin, but I just want to look, oh, see, nice. No redness, not dry, lush. My hand dirty. That's not attractive, is it? So that's number one. And what I'm going to do is move through because I'm aware of timings and I want to give you loads of time to ask questions at the end. Okay. So this is this one. This is the only one to repeat that you do not have samples of. Now you can splash it off. I take everything off the flannel. I'm just not a splasher or offerer. I love a flannel, but you don't have to. And also, I just have a feeling that this will become the mister's favorite because he loves anything that foams and anything that's easy. So all skin types. So as we go forward, if there are any particular skin types, I will make it known. None of these products contain animal byproducts before you ask. Let's have a look. Let's do micellar water. Okay. Cleansing micellar water. Obviously, if you are a double cleanser, this would be your first cleanse. So you could easily do your eyes or just a bit of makeup with this. And then you can follow it with this if you want to. But I will do lots of run throughs of like make-believe routines at the end, of course. This is not a drying foaming cleanser. And I take full responsibility for giving you the impression that everything that foams is the devil in the early days. This is not that. And what they've done with the sort of revamping of the original foaming cleansers, you're going to love. So micellar water. Now, if you are, if you don't wear a lot of makeup, you could probably skip this. However, if you wear any kind of eye makeup, mascara, liner, especially a heavy lip, and you don't like rubbing your eyes too heavy, you want to do something a bit more gentle, get these some cotton pads. Da, 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 da. You don't need a lot, by the way. I should hold that up higher, shouldn't I? Like this. And let's do, I don't think I've put anything on my forehead, but let's just see. I think I just threw some foundation on my cheeks so we'd have something to take off. Oh, there's like remnants, not much, but I'm not wearing a lot. But again, like it's not dried out. We're not going red. Super, super gently. Oh, there is more there, look. And to my experience, it'll be completely suitable for sensitive eyes. But anyone who's used it, if you've got any other feelings on that, let me know in the comments. I can't give you it just smells amazing and I can't tell you what it is. It's fresh. So it says Alpine Golden Gentian and Lemon Balm extracts. They all smell, you know when something smells really beautiful and soft and like skincare, but doesn't hang around for ages, it's like that. And yes, to your question, Linda, it is instead of eye makeup remover. This is your eye makeup remover. Now, I don't want you to get too excited. And I know you've seen it because you've got your samples, but we're on to a winner here, guys. Clarins have done a total cleansing oil. Sing choirs of angels. We all know how much I like a cleansing oil. We all know how much traditional French brands don't tend to dip into the sort of oil sector. So for them to do this, it's like made my day. It is, and I think it's almond oil. I'm gonna check my eyes. Yes, I believe it is an almond oil base. My days, honestly, I had a look through and everything and I was like, yeah, I remember all that. That's fantastic. Oh, it's sunflower. I'm full of shit. Sunflower. Don't tell anyone watching from Head Old Office that I was swearing, will you? So I'm just going to do one pump so you can see. Now, I would go straight into dry skin with this. I'm not going to do it yet because I want to show you everything else. But I would go straight onto dry skin like this and all over. Now, I prefer this to Pure Melt. If you remember, I was never a big fan of Pure Melt. Sorry, Clarin. I think there is still some Pure Melt available on the website if you're one of those people that's obsessed with it, because I know what it's like when you love something. Let me show you a better example so I can show you how it emulsifies. Now, if you add a little water, you get, it's just a much softer, sort of like an oil milk. Oh yeah, it's completely different to normal sunflower oil. It's a skincare sunflower oil. Don't worry, it's not the same. And it washes away clean. So if I just rinse and show you my hands rather than flannel. So if I dab rather than, so I want to give an impression of what your skin will look like, right? There, so it's not, we're not leaving like really greasy residue. Yes, you can use it for all skin types. Just checking comments. Face oil suitable for acne prone. I would say it's fine for acne prone. Clarins may disagree with me, but it's really, really light. And you do not have to do two things. You don't have to rub too hard to make it work, which is a real problem for some oils and especially balms with acne, with people who suffer from acne. And it rinses away really easily and you don't have to kind of drag your flannel across the face to get it off. Does that make sense? Are we good? For me, it's a first cleanse. So this would, yes, all over the eyes, destroys your eyes. Makeup. Make that clear, Caroline. So I would do oil and then this one, which I shouldn't call foam, we'll call it mousse because there's three foams. So I would do oil and then mousse. Or you can do micellar and then oil, or you can do micellar and then mousse. With me so far? Okay, oh, people doing it while we're talking. Good, okay, everyone's doing it while I'm talking. Good, what do we think of the oil? What do we think of the oil? Because you've got testers, obviously, samples. Marvis, love it, gorge, smells amazing. Oh, that makes me very happy. Good, okay, well done, Clarins, we approve. Now, this is probably my favorite. Okay, it's in my top three of theirs because I love the oil and I love the mousse. But you know what I'm like, and I love their original traditional cleansing milks. So the Velvet Cleansing Milk with Alpine Golden Gentian and Lemon Balm Extracts. Has anyone used this yet? I'll wait for your comments. Yes, I love it. Okay, the milk is just amazing. Yes, yes. Do you want us to use all clean? If you want to play and you're worried about your skin by putting seven cleansers on, for example, just do a cheek and then a forehead like I did, and then another cheek and then a chin. Do something like that. Make it work. Now this is Lush. So it's not, I mean, that's like enough for like two faces. You don't need lots. Why didn't I wear a t-shirt? What's wrong with me? So therapist swipe, all over both hands, and then straight on. Don't do this for half an hour. If you're new to me, if you take one thing away, don't do this for half an hour. You're just cleaning your hands. Get all of this onto your face. And yeah, you can use the oil first and then you can go in with the milk. You can use the milk first and then go in with the mousse. We'll do all of this first and second cleanse for the milk for me, first and second. Now I always flannel. Let me use my clean bowl. Sorry if the sound of water sounds strange. But that's how it is when it's runny. You're welcome to start, guys. Just keep using them. Just put them on, do what you need to do. Keep me talking in the background. Come back and tell us what you think. What do we think of the smells? See what I mean? Like, they smell amazing, but they're not overpowering. See, ooh, smells wonderful. Thank you. Yes, the smells are amazing. I concur. They are amazing. Now, so are you all right with where we are for the moment? Oh, and I'm good for time too. Excellent. You don't mind if we're here till 10, do you? They don't mind. Clarins won't cut us off. Okay, quick recap so far, the mousse. Now you don't have this, but it is super, super soft and fluffy. It is not ow, drying. Doesn't make your face feel like a raisin when you're left. Marvelous. let's do micellar next. Micellar water, mainly for either makeup removal, for me, makeup removal. It will also take off your, it'll break down your SPF. So if you want to do this as a first cleanse, just to sort of go easy with cotton over the face, you absolutely can. And then you can follow up with any of the others. Also great, if we're ever allowed out again, also fantastic to take away with you. And if anyone's going to any festivals that involves you camping, why would you? But if you want to do that, you would go here with some cotton. But glamping maybe. I'm not good with a tent, guys. I need my own sink. No, I don't say toilet, just my own sink. Total cleansing oil does what it says on the tin. None of these are too heavy to remove. None of them feel greasy. I like the people who are like, no to camping. So for me, the oil will be a first cleanse, but you can do first or second cleanse if you're only going to get one. You can do first and second cleanse. I would use something fresher in the morning. That's just me. And then the milk. Velvet. I also like the name. Well done, Clarins. Velvet cleansing milk. Okay, so we are up to everyone wants to go to the beach. Okay, good. Well done. Got to 55 without camping, not starting now. Angela, you are my people. Love festivals, love camping. Sorry, CH. I like a festival, just not the camping part. We all know when we're using this, we're all good. And I'll do a recap at the end and you can ping questions. Marvelous. Now, what we have, do you remember the Clarins, like cottonseed, the foaming cleansers that were? Yes. Oh, good. Okay. Do you take the cleansing milk off with water and flannel? I do. My life is, you apply the cleansing milk. Sorry, guys. I thought I did that. You do the cleansing milk same way as you do the others. Swipe all over the face, massage through, eyes, lip, all over, down the neck, and then you flannel off. I flannel off. You can splash if you absolutely want to. Of course, knock yourself out. I always apply to a dry skin. It's the therapist training. Like when someone comes in for a facial, we don't wet their face first. We get straight into it. So I always, you will always find me saying dry skin. I don't wet the skin first. So Clarins have updated, massively updated. They're three now. Foaming cleansers. Now this is gentle foaming cleanser. This is different from this. This is the mousse and it's pump activated. These ones, oh, now we're all here. Look, everyone's loving. Okay. Okay. What do we think? Are you going to play? So what we'll do is we'll say, I'm just going to give it to you like this and then I'll go in detail. If you are oily combination, you have spots, that's your concern, your pores, your concern, go green. Pick up the green one. And I know that you're saying I feel tight with foaming cleansings. Wait. If you are dehydrated, if your makeup disappears on your face, how would you know though? Are we wearing makeup at the moment? If your makeup disappears, which one is green? Sorry, purifying is green. Green is purifying, sorry. I can go by color. There's me trying to be, you know. So green, oh, sorry, all the boxes are white. Of course, in your little, okay. Sorry, purifying is green. If you are dehydrated, you want the hydrating one. So not necessarily dry, dry maybe, dry dehydrated, completely dependent upon what your main skin concern is. So hydrating is for you. Okay. And then soothing. Okay. So soothing is my face is sore. Everything makes me go red. Do you know what I mean? Anything like that. So best foaming for rosacea would be this one. So soothing is they don't have SLS. Would I be showing them to you if they did? Come on, Sabrina. Combination, you could do, well, assuming you're not particularly red, combination, you could do hydrating or purifying. Ooh, the soothing one is red. Red is a sore, angry color. My face feels a little tight. Would soothing suit a skin drained by retinol? Yep. But so would the oil would be good as well. Okay. So if you are concerned about playing with something you haven't used before, then just do soothing. Just be safe. Okay. And then So Nadine, who said green, little microexfoliant, it's not a microexfoliant, stay tuned, please. And then hydrating is technically yellow. But sorry, I was just giving you colours and you're like, they're in a box, Caroline, help. Okay, older nanny skin hydrating. Yeah, that would be me too. Thanks, Amelia. So I'll show you the purifying first. Now you will see here. So why don't you play with the purifying just so you can see it. The best cottonseed replacement, I probably say hydrating, but I will let them jump in and see if I'm wrong. Now, do you see those little blue bits? They are there to grab excess oil. It's not a scrubby situation. So they disperse when you massage it through. Massage it through and feel that. Now, the reason, I've just got this all over my nose. You're welcome. The reason these have souped up, let me just show you, I'll add a bit of water, is that you get loads of gentle foam with just a little bit of water. And look how far they spread. I could go up my arm, but I stupidly wore a sweatshirt. Aha. Feel nice. Now, all three of these cleansers contain squalane. I feel like I'm doing a school. You know, like if you're in school, you would go, can anyone tell me why? Oh, someone's going to join us. Can anyone tell me why they all contain squalane? Come on. If you watch me, you'll know. You know. Come on. Hydration. The slip. Hydration. Well done, Laura. You got in there first. Oh, and super soothing. Yeah, it will stop the... it'll stop the foaming action of the cleansers from drying your skin out. So you only need a little bit and add more water, not more product, to make it foam. So traditionally, a sodium lauryl sulfate based product, if you think of a shampoo or, I mean, a fairy liquid, if you want to go to an extreme, but we're not comparing those to that, obviously. You will find that you need a little bit and you add water and it just explodes with foam. When you take away that really, really strong synthetic surfactant and use ones that are usually based around coconut, that kind of thing, you have to add more water, not more product. So if you're using, I'm just going to jump in with a bit of hydrating. If you're using one of these, and I'm doing a tiny on purpose, you can put it on like this, but the minute you add water, it starts to build and spread. Oh, hello. You saw how little I used. So don't use too much. So the mousses should last ages. Yes, all of these will last you ages. I'm just going to say this, as long as you don't leave them in the shower near your husband or your kids who think that everything's on tap, we might as well use a third of a pump. What's the problem? So that's those two. Now let's do toners quickly and then we can do a recap. And then I think they're going to shut me up soon. It's like the Oscars when you win an award and they shut you up, except I'm washing bits of my body on a camera as you do. Please, can you tell my daughter, Rosie, to listen and get off social media? Rosie, get off social media and pay attention. Do as your mother says. You will notice three matching colours corresponding tone. Yes, you can rinse it off. Rinse it off with a flannel. If you're doing it at the sink, take yourself to the sink. Now you can splash. Why don't you try one side splash, one side flannel and see how you feel? Okay, so for these, for me, I use these as a skin cleanser. I don't put these on the eye, and Clarins have been very, very clever. So I'll give you an example. I don't know if you'll see these on the sample sizes, but when you get the big product, there are three symbols there. I'll try and see if that, can you see there, right? There are three symbols. One is a face, one is an eye, and one is a lip. That tells you what you can and can't, you shouldn't use them on. They don't appear on here. They don't appear on here. I'm a poet and I didn't know it. So these are skin cleansers in the way that I've always said, one's gonna take your makeup off and your SPF off, the others are for your skin. And we'll do a recap as well at the end, okay? I like the matching colors because I'm so lazy. There you go. So if you were green, you would do purifying toning lotion, combination to oily skins, this one. Oh, I'd just like to have another look. Glycerin, third ingredient. See, that's so nice. We've moved on from just alcohol laden toners. Not that Clarins did that anyway. But you know, like really stripping toners. Oh, glycerin, third ingredient, Lush. Hydrating, your main ingredient is aloe. I'm double checking myself. And then Soothing. Oh, I love the smell of this one. Glycerin again. Oh, lush. Let's have another whiff, shall we? I'm easily pleased. I like the matching colours. Would you say toning is a must? No. But when you do it, you notice the benefit. And like I said, because these aren't laden with alcohol, like they were, again, not Clarins, but certain other ones were for a long, long time, and some still are, these are your first step of hydration. And they're also the first thing that stays on your skin, remember? So you've got glycerin and aloe working across all three. And so you're gonna have, you will tone, in the Clarins world, you would cleanse, then tone. And Clarins will also show you there's a very specific movement they do that I can't be bothered to do because I'm too lazy. And in my experience, most of you feel the same way, so I completely ignored them. I'm sorry, I love you, please don't find me. But these, you will find, let's just give you a little demo. Pick a colour, any colour, pink, yellow, green. Soothing, let's do that. Okay, here we go. Best toner for acne is the green, purifying. Okay, so the soothing, if you look, is slightly thicker. You're not going to see anything, it's white cotton, Caroline. Help the people out. So the soothing sort of sits into your cotton a bit more. Let's just tone my forehead, shall we? Oh. Now, funnily enough, because I've done it without water, there's just a little bit of... See, there's some left. That's why in the old days you would cleanse and then tone to take off the residue. But when you're using flannel and splashing, you're fine. You do not have to use cotton pads. I do. I just feel like it's weird. To me, I just feel like I know it sounds strange because people say that they're worried you waste it when you put it on cotton. I feel like I waste it when I put it on my hand. I know it makes no sense. But as with everything skincare, as with serums, eye creams, SPF, the best skincare is skincare that you will use. That makes sense? Can you remove cleanser with toner? You can do, absolutely. Would you use a two-stage cleanse and then tone? Yeah, you would still do two stages and then tone for sure. Just cleansed with the Velvet Milk, total Palmer Violet loveliness. Nice. Is the soothing toning lotion more of an essence? It feels like more of an essence for sure. It's a bit richer. Always a cotton pad. Micellar than cleansing foam. I love that you're already deciding what you're doing. Okay, good. Your hands are so soft. I love all of it. Marvelous. So what is a toner to hydrate? So in the olden days, a toner would be, you would cleanse, you would tone to make sure that you've taken off any residual cleanser product, and also to reset the pH balance of your skin, right? In the olden days, some of us are, remember, will you purge trying on new products? Not with these, no, you should be absolutely fine. But now, and especially brands like Clarins, whose job is to work on skin, because don't forget, a lot of skincare brands are available, never touch people's faces. Clarins touch skin for a living, that's what they do. So taking feedback and putting things like glycerin into the toners means that they are in essence a leave-on essence, if you like. And there was a great question: is double toning a thing, e.g. purifying followed by hydrating? I know it contains glycerin anyway, but just wondering. That's the kind of thing I would do. You're clearly my people, Nadine. That is the kind of thing I would do. Just found my Clarins parcel in a wheelie bin. At least you found it. Get it open, love. So in a way, it depends. And look, you don't rinse toner off. No, it stays on your face. You don't rinse toner off. Let's have a look. I love the peach one, so it's been discontinued. What would you recommend instead? If you're lazy, go for the micellar water or the mousse if you can. I mean, I assume when you say you're lazy, Estelle, you don't mean you don't bathe. Because you could always just whack a bit of this on in the morning just to make sure your skin is fresh. But for laziness, you're probably going down this road. Oil, micellar water or mousse. The mousse was called Gentle Renewing Cleansing Mousse. So put toner on with a cotton pad, just pat on as I usually seem to rub it in. Oh no, I rub it in. I mean, I literally windscreen wipe it all the way down the face, turn it over, go all the way up again. Shall we do questions? I don't know if they want to rejoin me and take over, but I can do recaps of routines and things like that if that's helpful. All products, all ages, all skin types, unless, of course, if you're super dry, you don't need to be going near the purifying. If you're really oily, you would find probably the velvet cleansing milk, maybe a bit much. If you're really oily, you might find the cleansing oil a bit much. Do you see what I mean? So go by your skin type, but bear in mind that Clarins are gentle enough that nothing is going to give you the heebie-jeebies and anything scary, right? You want to recap. Okay, I can do a recap. So do you want a recap of what order you would use things in, or just do it? Should we just go for it and do general? You don't rinse off micellar water. That's kind of the point of it. It's for speed and to sort of break down first, like makeup, SPF, that kind of thing. Okay, so the mousse. The mousse you are not going to put on your eyes. The mousse is a skin cleanser. So for me, it is a perfect PM second cleanse or morning cleanser. Are we good with the mousse? Questions? There's no eye symbol on it, so we're going to avoid the eye area. Okay, good. And don't forget, there'll be a Q&A at the end, so don't worry. Just think of your questions if I don't get to you, as it were. Cleansing micellar water. Okay, cleansing micellar water is, I wear makeup or I'm lazy, I don't wear that much. Also, let's not underestimate the amount of people, especially in a time of a pandemic with COVID, that have been ill or a rundown or have long COVID, who find it hard to function, literally. And a lot of people message and say, can you just give me something that helps when I'm on the sofa? I can't move, I can't go to the sink. You want micellar water. Get yourself micellar water, okay? So really popular with, like, Ava loves a micellar water. There's something I think therapeutic for a certain demographic of putting micellar water on a cotton pad and watching all the hard work that you put on sort of come off in front of you. Micellar was my savior when I was in bed with COVID. Exactly, there you go. I hope you're all very healthy, by the way. I had my jab today, woohoo! So you're good, because you got me before apparently after 12 hours, you get a bit tired and rough. I'm good. I might message you all tomorrow being like, help me. Cleansing oil. So cleansing oil is, hard to go wrong. It's like a one-stop shop. So if in doubt and you want makeup off and everything off like that, cleansing oil is the quickest. It's like, oh my God, I haven't got the energy. Boom, done. Okay. I love seeing my mascara melt off at the end of the day. Yeah, completely. Does the cleansing oil go on dry skin? It does for me. Let's see what Clarins say, shall we? Let's give them some say in the matter. Clearly, I can't even read it because it's too small. I'm sure they'll come on and they'll all be sitting there going, Caroline, for God's sake. I apply on dry skin. Problem is, because this emulsifies, if you wet your face when you put it on, it won't work as well. For me, you want the oil to grab the oil and the dirt on your skin. Make sense? Yes, it will take your eye makeup off. Okay? You don't double cleanse in the morning. Well, unless you want to, but there's not really a need. Double cleanses for the evening. Double cleanses, I'm wearing stuff on my face. I need to get it off. I'll do it properly. Morning is, I've got bits on my face that are sort of dead skin cells because I'm using products at night that help stimulate cell turnover, and I get flakier and I want to wash it all off, but quickly. Okay? Do you need to double cleanse if you don't wear makeup? No, but if you're wearing a really heavy SPF, I would go over it twice, even if it's lightly. Do you know what I mean? Oil is the first cleanse, or your only cleanse. Like I put foundation around here and I put mascara on. I'll only probably use this tonight, although I'm very tempted to follow it with the mousse because it feels so lovely. And yes, I just do flannel personally. You can splash, but I do a flannel. Okay. And then velvet cleansing milk. Now, this would traditionally be one that I would instinctively pick up because I know I'm not going to go wrong with a Clarins milk cleanser. They've never set me adrift with a milk cleanser personally. And also, this will do all your makeup and it will clean your skin. So if you want a proper one-stop shop, for me, it would be the milk. Sorry, I'm not trying to confuse you. It's just that there's so many options and they do that because there's so much demand. So the milk is going to be softer. It is for me and my skin, because I'm 51, ladies, you know, and gents, don't be sexist. You can absolutely use the milk if you have acne-prone skin, because you can gently, it comes off gently. The problem you'll have if you have acne-prone skin is if you're using a rich, thick balm that you have to massage on, which you don't really want to be doing because it's hard to get it moving. And then also you have to take it off with a flannel, but you really have to rub with it. And as you'll know very well, I'm sure, if you have active acne, i.e. you have whiteheads, blackheads, pustules, papules, you will potentially make your skin bleed. Nobody wants to do that. All of these are suitable for teenagers. All of these. So I should say goodbye to them now, frankly, because they won't last as soon as they oversee them. Do clones not go down the acid or retinol road? No, they're very traditional. So they used to have an acid, if you remember. And I'm sure they'll work on something along that. But, you know, there is a nod to acid in terms of really gentle, which is always going to be Clarins way. They're not going to do anything that's going to really annoy your face. It is always going to be gentle. But the mousse has a very gentle AHA action. I'll say that quietly or my daughter will steal them. Sorry. Which would be easier to wash out of a beard area? Oh, Chris Jennings, good question. Probably the mousse. Probably the mousse. And I will make a big assumption that if you're wearing a beard, you're not going to be wearing heavy makeup. Don't want to make an assumption and be sexist, but I'm just assuming. So the mousse would be good because you can splash it. And I know the mousse is going to be Jim's favourite. I know it is. Do you apply the milk with a cotton pad? No, I go straight onto my hands. I haven't got time. Can't be bothered. Can't be bothered. So everything is suitable for teens. Everything is suitable for pregnancy and breastfeeding. Everything is suitable for all skin tones. Everything is suitable for all skin types and all skin conditions. But you will instinctively know if you have an oilier skin, you'll err towards, you'll be like, oh, maybe I should go down the purifying road. If you're really dry, you'll know that purifying sounds like it would be too much for you. That makes sense. Can you use a toner just in the morning as a cleanse? No, if you're going to do that, use the micellar water. Because the micellar water has properties in it to remove from the skin. A toner is about putting back in. If you have absolutely no problems with your skin whatsoever and you want to do that, knock yourself out. I mean, you're doing something, let's face it. And then these three, they all come with the matching toner, but don't forget, you can use all of the toners after the other four cleansers too. So no one's saying in order to sort of get on board, you have to buy six products. That is not what Clarins is saying. Can't choose between hydrating and soothing, which works best, dry skin. I'd go hydrating if you're dry. If you are, do we use the milk on dry or wet skin? Dry, dry. If Clarins come on and say wet, I'll be like, I'm really sorry, but I would just still use it on dry. Please don't argue with me. So purifying gentle foaming cleanser is this one. This is one that has the bits in it, but they're not, I'm using your language so you know what we were talking about. They're not exfoliating bits. They break down on the skin and they're oil absorbent. And then soothing is, I'm worried that everything's going to hurt my face. I'm going to use this. These are your second cleansers or morning cleansers. Remember, milk is both. Milk is a one-stop shop. You can use it to take your makeup off. You can use it to wash your face to keep your skin fresh. And then hydrating, gentle foaming cleanser. Now, see, there would have been a time where that would be like an oxymoron. You'd be like, how could you have a hydrating foaming cleanser? But they are really, really soft. I hope Clarins will make the large sizes with the pump, like the current ones. I like large sizes of everything Clarins makes, thanks. Soothing cleanser straight into dry skin, yes. Could you use pink as an overnight mask? No, these are cleansers, they're not masks. Menopausal Mary with hot red skin due to hormones. Mary, you're gonna come down the soothing. Think pink, think my face is pink. I need a bit pink, okay? Would I moisturize after toning as my skin now feels tight after using the toner? Yeah, crack on. Sorry, don't wait for me. Stick a moisturizer on. Squalane is in the foaming cleansers. Exactly, all of these. Which product is best for massage? Oh, that's a good question. Well, you would instinctively say the oil, but the milk is great for massage. And these are good for, these spread easily. Do you know what I mean? Mum on chemo, what cleanser's good for her? Mum on chemo, I would do soothing and the oil. The oil, because if she's really knackered, she can just splash her face and it will emulsify and she can splash it off. And the soothing, because chemo is known for drying out your skin and inflammation and redness, and it brings heat to your skin. So I would go soothing. And just to clarify, I'm saying that Clarins might tell you to speak to your doctor, just to be clear, but you will be fine, trust me. Mum not in the country and she's already ordered the oil for her birthday. I I'm with your mum. Which cleanser is best if you have an oily T-zone? Purifying. I have very combination skin, but also blemish prone. Which foam would be for me? I would just stick with the purifying. It really doesn't feel that strong, that stripping. I really wouldn't worry. Then is it just a moisturiser after toning? Yes. So get your moisturiser on. And then I think Charlotte's going to join us again. Are any of these good for blackheads on the nose? Green. Routine suggestions for dehydrated skin. Oh, good. Yes, pink would be best for Tret face. I could just sit here and do a Q&A all day. I love this. Psoriasis, I would go soothing or the milk. The milk is also really sort of softening, but it depends. If you're in any major doubt, and let's not get onto extra comfort cleansing cream. No, let's not do that at all. If you're in any doubt and you think, I want comfort, I always go to oil for comfort as a first. So if you want comfort, I would do oil and soothing. Okay. Are you allowed to tell us top clearance products? Let's do that at the end when we do the Q&A. Okay. Charlotte, are you going to join us again?
Well, you've done a really good job of answering loads of the questions, but because people are typing rapido, we have managed to pluck a few out that you might have missed. People are getting quite specific as well with their skin. So I'm just going to sift through and see a few here that we might not have...
Could I not have moved my charger, my portable charger that's charging? Could I not have moved that out the way for this, do we think?
I like it. It's realism.
Could I not have just like hid it before we started? And look at this plug. That's not attractive. I do apologise.
I reckon they'll forgive you, you know. So we did have the question about the beard, but you've just answered that one. I don't know if it was the same questioner, Chris, but I hope that Caroline's answered your question there about your beard. It would be the foam. Julia has asked, I have very sensitive skin. Always gets super drying feeling from cleansers that you need to use water to take off. Okay. So what would you recommend?
If you're sensitive and your skin gets dry, I would do the milk. And you can also remember, you don't have to take it off with a flannel. You can take it off with damp cotton pads. I mean, I'm just going, that's old school. But that would be my sort of instinct would be, don't do anything that's going to foam if you're sensitive and dried. It'll be too much work to get them off, and it could just leave you feeling that sort of tight feeling. So I would be tempted to do the milk and the soothing toner. I don't know what you would say. That's just me chucking out there.
No, I agree with you completely, because the way that she's worded it as well.
By the way, did you tell them what you do for a living so they know why they should listen to you?
Oh, I haven't told. I think I told them at the beginning. So I'm the commercial training manager for Clarins. So I know a bit about what I'm saying. But everything that you've said, Caroline, was perfect. There's nothing that needs changing.
Like when you dropped it in there, I know a bit about what I'm saying, and I'm like, oh, I'm really sorry. Did I say it all wrong?
No, it was perfect. Absolutely perfect. But Julia, what you've said there as well is that the way that Julia's worded that question, it's almost like the water is the problem. So yeah. I agree with you, Caroline, that the milk would work really well. If you've tried loads of different things with water, don't quit the cleansing, quit the water. That's what I think is probably a better way of doing it. So another question, Joanna, are these cleansers for skin of all ages?
Oh yeah. Yeah. I mean, I'm not going to lie. I don't think Ava would be particularly, I mean, she would use it if I told her to, but I think she would use the milk because she's been trained, but most teenagers would see this as something for their mum. I think just talking as the mum of a teenage girl, you know, I think they will go here and she would like the oil. So Ava, for teenagers, I'm guessing she might join us and just be like, absolutely not. But I think she would go oil for ease, micellar water for festival season, and mousse for the morning. Charlotte is beautiful. There you go.
Oh, I'll take it. Thanks so much. It's a very, very fancy camera. I agree. I think the thing is with ages as well, we don't pigeonhole them. We don't pigeonhole anyone by age. At Clarins, particularly with regard to cleansers, because it's to do with method preference and skin type. And you can be 15 and dry or 85 and oily. It's not as likely, but it can happen. So no, don't worry too much about the age. Just get what suits your skin best. What cleanser is best, Caroline, for rosacea?
I mean, my instinct would be to say soothing, though. But having said that, people with rosacea sometimes feel that anything that's foaming could be a bit tight. So I would also say, here's where it comes from. I don't know who asked the question. I will use your name, rosacea person. But
it's Maria.
Maria, I would say, there's two types of rosacea people. Are you someone who doesn't put anything on their face because it's sore? Or are you someone who uses a lot of makeup to cover your rosacea? Because if that's the case, I would do the oil. Because the oil, to me, doesn't seem like it's going to cause any further harm. I don't think anything will, but just for particularly for rosacea. And then maybe the milk. What would you say, boss?
I completely agree with you. I completely agree with you. I think the rosacea is one thing on its own. You know what irritates you if you've got rosacea. But again, it's to do with what you're removing. Because we're talking cleansers, it needs to be about what you're taking off and what's going to effectively cleanse. It's very unlikely that any of these cleansers will irritate rosacea, but it might just be your preference, again, similar to the previous question, to avoid using water for whatever reason. And you can't go wrong with the milk if you've got any of these kind of concerns. I like a milk myself, but I also like an oil. What can I say? So we've got here as well. Oh, Claire's asked, which cleanser do you reckon is best for removing mascara?
Oh, well, see, my instinct, you would say micellar water, but for me, I always go for an oil. And I know that I could be that sort of, I'm older, so it could just be me, but I would say oil.
But I'm with you. I'm completely with you.
Use a micellar water first, but I love an oil.
I am completely with you on that. I've been using the Total Cleansing Oil for a week, and it's the makeup destroyer. So if you've got eye makeup on like me tonight and you want to whip it off, then you can't go wrong with the oil. The micellar will remove makeup, and it'll remove lightweight makeup. It won't remove waterproof mascara though, so that's where the oil would be ideal. Yeah, I'm all for it. We've answered the teenager question. Right, Alexandra would like to know when she should use the foaming cleansers. So I assume by that question she means when in her cleansing routine.
So for me, it would be a second cleanse or a morning cleanse. Because it's not designed to remove makeup, it's a skin cleanser.
100% agree. Right, Kerry wants to know, does she apply the foaming cleansers to dry skin?
I would, but we know I'm awkward. So if you find that my instinct is to say try it, because you're not going to be using it to do makeup, right? But you can certainly, you'll get more out of it if you add a bit of water, for sure, like I demoed on my hands. So if you get it onto your fingers, maybe I'll concede a splash from the tap rather than this. A splash from the tap, wet, so you're not really soaking your face wet, but you're wetting the product to get it on. How's that?
Yeah, sounds good. I think you can use it dry. If you, I know that you're not a huge fan of this, Caroline, because you can't be bothered, which is fair enough, but the suction cleanse that Clarins do, that does work really well with the foaming cleanser dry to kind of get that initial pull away from, and then add in the water to kind of rinse and foam it away is a really nice way of doing it. But I also appreciate that quite a lot of the time, if you've chose a foaming cleanser, it's because you're in a bit of a hurry and you've chosen it for convenience. So either or would work perfectly.
Demo the suction, Charlotte.
Yes. So if you were to use a suction cleanse, which you can do with milk, gentle foaming cleanser.
And oil. I can totally do it with the oil.
You could probably do it with the oil. I'm not sure it's sticky enough to try. Don't know if you get the pull. Give it a go. So the suction cleanse, you would apply the products, whatever it is you're choosing to use, to a dry face. And then you're going to do this. So you're going to touch your skin quite firmly and then pull away as though you're hot. So you kind of do this quick draw away from the skin. You do it in rows. So what you're doing is you're replicating what we would do in the Clarins Skin Spa. And like this, you see. So it does work really well. You get this lovely kind of sound pulling the muck away from your face.
Does anyone work?
super squelchy afterwards.
It's a squelch.
It's a good squelch noise, and that's how you know you're doing it absolutely right. Somebody's put the French method. Sounds a bit posher than suction cleanse. I'll take it. Good. Oh, here's a question. Natalie would like to know, of this new cleansing range, pick a top three.
You go first then.
Okay. So my number one is Total Cleansing Oil. This is my first cleanse in the evening every single day from now on forever. That's what I've decided.
Statement there, Charlotte.
I know. I mean, someone would have to really knock it off the top spot. So that would be my first cleanse. My second cleanse. Oh, I'm a bit torn now because I've only just had the mousse delivered. All right. Well, I was doing the hydrating gentle foaming cleanser. So this was my first and second cleanse.
I should be while you're chatting. I'll pick while you chat.
All right. Yeah, you work out what you're up to. Though, if those are my top one and two, I reckon the cleansing mousse is going to be my number three, and this is going to be my morning cleanse. I am a lazy bones in the morning, so I think this is in the shower, all over the face, get it sorted, and then at night time, take my time a bit more, remove all the slack, and get it sorted. So those are my top three. What about you? Yours different?
Yeah. Only one, though. You know, okay. You know where it's going to be as well. So mine is also oil, also mousse. Nice morning, and I can't say no to the milk.
We knew it was coming. We absolutely knew it was coming. Oh, Stacey's shouting at me there for doing it in the shower.
That's me. I've taught them. That's me. Sorry about that.
I know, but look how loyal they are to those rules. It's amazing. Okay, good. So those were the top three. We've got Irina. She's asking, which cleanser would you recommend for a teenage boy that has recently started breaking out with spots on the chin and nose?
I mean, my instinct would be two choices based on the fact that I have a teenage boy and I know the only two he would be interested in. Mm-hmm. For speed, it would be mood or purifying.
Yeah, I would agree completely. I think that's
just max. Anything that you can do for a hurry.
Yeah. Also, I don't want to generalize, but green's one of those colors that teenage boys can live with. As well, when you're telling them about, you know, skincare, maybe if you showed them the soothing one, many of them wouldn't be as chuffed.
It's pink.
Mm. Yeah, exactly. They don't want to feel like they're borrowing the mum's skincare, even though they are.
I would just say to them as well, with the teenage boys, it's important that they do put a little bit of moisture back on, because a lot of the time they think they're just going to scrub their face in the shower and then shoot off. Whereas actually, if they do something like, you know, even just a really light moisturizer from the MyClarins range, which is the young skin range, I call it the teen range, I would be tempted just to make sure that you persuade them to use a moisturizer afterwards. It only has to be a teeny bit, but once they've used it, they feel the difference.
Yeah, I agree. I think that's the best one. Someone's Emma has asked, would you tone and then use a hyaluronic acid?
Well, yeah, because hyaluronic acid is as a serum for hydration. So you would tone and then use. So in Clarins, and I always go by colours, in Clarins, if you want to use anything hyaluronic, it's all blue.
Yes.
You could call it Hydra and be professional. But for you guys, if you're looking on the website for speed, go blue. If you're dehydrated, you want blue. So, yeah, it would come afterwards because, like I say, the toners are the first thing that you're leaving on the skin. And the hyaluronic acid will go in there.
Perfect. Good advice. And you're absolutely right. All the blue range is the Hydra range, but it is all in white boxes. So ask for Hydra when you go into the store. But yes, it is the blue one.
When we get back into store, oh my God.
I mean, it's round the corner, isn't it? It's fingers crossed everything goes to plan. It's less than a month now. We will see you in there. I can't wait to visit the store.
Can you believe it? Like if they'd have said, last year, you'll still be here this time next year. We all would have just lost our minds, wouldn't we?
100%.
I do wonder if we would have planned a bit more, though. I do wonder if I finally would have, you know, done some Italian app learning lessons or something. You know, like, probably not. I probably would have just stayed and done what I've done, which is cooking and watch SVU.
To be fair, I've just decorated and watched Netflix. So all of the above. But now time is short. I've suddenly got projects I want to do.
Yeah.
So somebody else has asked, let me just find where I'm up to on this. Adrian has asked, beautiful name, Adrienne, what cleanser is best for menopausal skin, which has some spots slash rash, but also dryness?
Okay, so if you're menopausal, hi, my people. Just shout out to the girls. I would be prone to say oil and milk. And I'll tell you for why. Because when you're menopausal, as I now am, I'm not perimenopausal anymore. I'm menopausal, they've told me. Like, they're quite blunt with it too. Well, maybe we should have that conversation another time. But they're very like, oh yes, this shop is closed. Thanks. But it's directly, your ovaries are directly linked to your collagen supply. And so your collagen is depleted. So my collagen's gone on holiday and ain't coming back. Okay, so I now have to fake it till I make it. So I would instinctively go for anything that will add oil to my skin. Even though I'm going to wash this off, my skin will go, oh, lovely. Oh, I haven't had a bit of oil on my face for a long time with this dried up old bird. And then this also has the difference between this and this. So the foaming and the milk is the milk will have a higher oil content, which is why I always, I would say for the past 5 years, I've kind of mainly stayed with oils and milks. The odd lovely foaming cleanse when I just want to be, you know, oh, I need something fresh. But for me, I would go mousse because it feels so light. Make sense? Menopause is harsh and goes on forever. HRT, love. Another story, but yeah. I'm sleeping much better using blue orchid oil at night. Oh my God. That's like one of the best smelling products ever made.
I think it smells like Terry's chocolate orange. I'm telling you now. And somebody said that they thought it smelled like fries cream, is it? Chocolate bar?
I hate chocolate orange. I would not put it on my face if that was the case. It is.
Really?
I hate.
Okay, scrap that. Rewind, erase.
Together. It's like pineapple on a pizza. Why would you do that?
Oh, this could be a whole other life.
I hate. Don't be put off. I love blue orchid oil. It is.
I also love it, but I also love Terry's chocolate orange. So that's slightly different. We've got a couple more questions. We are coming to the end of these now. Emma has asked, what would be your favourite first cleanse as a makeup removal if you had to pick one?
For me.
Yeah.
Oil.
Me too.
It's just a no-brainer. Oil is so good for removing makeup, and it also helps to break down SPF. So for me, it would be oil.
Mm-hmm. I couldn't agree more. Perfect.
Absolutely. After upsetting you about pineapple on pizza.
I didn't even say what my opinion is on that because I feel like it will be really divisive because no matter what you pick, it's divisive. Zara has asked, best cleanser for a 20-year-old with dry skin and occasional spots?
Oh, she could pick any of them. Let's face it.
It's a bit all over the place.
I would pick whatever you like the look of, my darling. And also, you've probably got like what I would call most people would class that a normal skin. You know, the occasional spot. And also, what is a normal skin these days? You know, does it really exist?
No.
No.
So it never really has. No. It's just the word we have to use so everyone knows what we mean.
I mean, a regular skin to me is someone who has fairly good tone, fairly good elasticity, breaks out occasionally because it's hormones, right? We are supposed to.
Absolutely.
Like I would pick whatever you know you're going to use. The main problem I found with 19, 20 year olds is, no offense, I'm sure you're much, much easier to handle than my child, but it's, if they find something they love, they will use it. They will very rarely like when we're older, we're like, oh, I really don't want to do this, but I've got to make the effort because time's running out, frankly, and I've got to do everything I can. When you're 20, come on. You're like, oh, I'm going to look like this. Whatever I do, I'll use whatever I like.
It's not true, guys. Prepare. But yeah, I agree, use whatever you prefer. I would probably, just based on your description, probably recommend the hydrating foaming cleanser, the yellow one, because that's going to hydrate you, but without adding kind of, you know, a heavier feeling on the skin. You'll feel really clean, but you won't feel tight. It'll help keep the skin cleansed. It's just going to kind of do everything for you. So I'd probably go for that one if I had to pick one, but you've got the samples there, so pick which one you like the best. Final question for you, which is from Holly. She has asked, and it's completely off topic, is there a Clarins serum that you would recommend?
How old is she?
She hasn't said, actually. Holly, if you're listening, give us a ballpark. She's 33. She's just come through. There you go.
You can't go wrong with double serum, can you?
No. I mean, I was hoping you were going to say that, Caroline.
No, I mean, my instinct would be double serum just because you can't go wrong. Obviously, if you are, Holly, if you have really dehydrated skin, then look for something in the Hydra range. But I would still put double serum on top of that because I'm a savage, frankly.
Yeah. I mean, I'm not going to argue with you. I could talk about double serum for about 45 minutes without stopping for breath, but I can't because it's 7 o'clock. I just realized this. However, I have got some kind of advice to give about where you can get more information if you need more information about that. Caroline, I just want to say thank you so much.
My pleasure.
It was so informative. What an absolutely brilliant event. I think everybody's had a brilliant time. And I know that everyone just wants to go away and take all the makeup off if they haven't done already. So virtual round of applause, I'm sure, from everybody that's watching. You can have an actual one from me. It's been an absolute pleasure. Thank you so much.
Joining us all, ladies.
It's what, sorry?
Gents. I said, thank you for joining us all, ladies. And I was like, and gents, am I so sexist today?
It's, I know, well, you can't say anything, you get yourself in trouble, but I can see a lot of ladies' names there, so I think you're safe. But yeah, big turnout tonight. And everyone, just a reminder of what the code is, because I know that many of you missed it at the beginning, and I don't want you to shout at either of us. The code, which is redeemable for your £10 redeemable code on the website, is CHCLEANSE. That's all one word, all in capitals, CHCLEANSE. That is available on a purchase over £50, and it's a £10 discount. And the code is valid until this Sunday, so Sunday the 21st. Somebody asked me exactly what time it expires. It will be valid all of that day. Don't try it after midnight. I think that's the best thing. And also, just as a reminder to you, I know when you registered for the event, you had to register with a specific email address. The code will only work with that email address. So you need to make sure that you're logged into the website before you use it to make sure that it does apply properly. Just a quick reminder as well, our virtual boutique team, where you can get expert advice, are open until 8 p.m. this evening to take your calls or to take your live chat. So if you do want to know more about double serum, for example, you could contact them and get a little bit of info. I hope that you've all enjoyed this evening. I've had a ball. Caroline, once again, thank you so much for joining us. It's been an absolute pleasure.
It goes so quick.
Flown, absolutely flown by. And that's it from us, everyone. So I shall say goodbye. It's been an absolute pleasure. Take care and have a lovely evening. Thank you very much.
Thank you, everyone.